Koos Capgras, ons het nou ondergestop in Koper. Hierso. Volgende een kleefmiddel op plakate tegen die muur te plak. Wat kan ons gebruik om het op te plak? Wondergom of prijstiek? Okay. Ja, adhesives to stick. Posters to the wall will be prijstiek. Posters. Please do not use super glue. You will rip off the paint, CJ. Die onderwijzers af, jy moet die kop skiet. Toe ek in Robertson gewerk het, mag ons net posters vastgeplak het met sellotape. Just sellotape.
Is it because the paint is so dry?
The paint itself is the paint itself pulls out. Right. Difference between cohesion and adhesion. This is an English thing. Cohesion, inherent strength of the adhesive. Adhesion, ability of the molecules of an adhesive to cling to the molecules of another substance. Nou vir die Afrikaans, cohesie en adhesie. Interheerende, cohesie, nie coalisie nie. Nie hy nie. En adhesie. En die hete sterkte van die kleefmiddels soos cohesie is, hoe sterk is die kleefmiddels soos prit, gaan 'n swakker cohesie as superglue of lijm. En adhesie, die vermoë van die gom om te klou aan die ding wat jy hom aan vasplak. So die gom, byvoorbeeld houtlijm, JP, gaan nie werk op staal nie. Okay. You understand? So the glue that you can use to stick to a substance, that is the adhesion. The ability of the glue to stick to a substance. Now, if you want to go test something funny, try to put super glue in a non-stick pan.
But does it actually work? What? No, I didn't do that.
No.
Test it.
So test it before. And then, boom.
Drie voorzorgmaatregels wat gevolg moet word wanneer ons met glasvezel werk. When working with fiberglass, the following things must be done. Masker en een gezichtmasker. Katalysator en versneller. Moet die altijd apart wees. Goggles.
And so you mustn't breathe it in.
Yes. Verwijder alle haars en versneller van die vel. Why are you laughing? Because Bradley was doing...
What?
Points.
Oh, because it's a habit now.
Yeah. Dra handskoene as jou vel sensitief is. If you've got a sensitive skin because you use dawn cream or something, wear gloves. Gebruik acetoon om die goed geventileerde areas. Guys, when using acetone, use it in a good ventilated area. Hanteer verdamp, maar die dampe man. Al verdamp hy. Hy slaat vir jou nog steeds.
Did you in the face?
Mm.
Ja.
Klap jy soos gom in 'n plastic bottle. Hy hanteer gegrote haars versigtig. Dit is bros en kan maklik breek. So guys, work. When you have your fiberglass CJ, you can't run with it. You have to walk carefully with it. Glasvezel mat. Het klein stukkies vezel wat die vel kan bingedring. The fiberglass penetrates your skin and it starts itching, ja. En moenie glasvezel inasem en in jou oor laat kom hê. So wat Nathan vir my die universele Delabat language gegooi het, die goggle. Not in your eyes and don't inhale, it will get stuck. It can cause blindness, dit kan blindheid veroorsaak om 'n bietjie glasvezel in die oor te kry. As jy met fiberglass werk, en jy die toe kleren aan nie, dan is jy maar 'n bietjie toe.
Jy gaan
juk.
I mean dood, hè? Not the other word, frick.
Okay.
So, these days everyone to say frick.
Een plaasbestuurder moet die veiligheidsplakate in die plaaswinkel, ons het klaar opgezet. Hierso, elektrische heinings is baie gewilde, veeldoelige en doeltreffende vorm van omheining. Vir beide tydelike en permanente heining. So electric fence is now a very popular thing, especially in South Africa, for safety and all of that nice things. Everybody, yeah, fight the power. Eskom power. So,
Eskom.
Just make sure your generator is strong. So, we still have to talk to those Americans. Ik moet nog met hulle praat. You can't say stuff like that. You can't say hulle gaan jou generator steal in Zuid-Afrika. Oh, steal hulle loop. Steal die cement om hom. Noem 5 veiligheidsregulaties wat op elektrische heining van toepassing is. Nou, 5 safety regulations for electric fences. Moet geen elektrische gevaar vir mense, diere of die omgeving inhou nie. So there must be no electrical danger for any animal or human or the environment that's causing a fire or stuff like that.
And so
must
you put a post saying there's a...
Yes, there has to be borkies on you.
And it must be visible.
Mm. Elektrische heiningconstructie wat geneig is om tot die verstrengeling van diere of persone te lei, moet vermy word. Guys, when you construct the fence, make sure that the person that touches the fence does not get stuck, CJ. So no akies eraan.
No barbed wire.
No barbed wire. Don't build it so if somebody does climb and they get caught, they can't get away. Because they say for animals, to protect animals as well, you moet seker maak die dier sit nie vas in hom. Ek sien Roelof lag daar as een waar onwettig hier op die plaas aangaan.
It's a girl on your farm, so you shoot them or you just need one, you should catch
we don't shoot them. I don't even have a gun. Let's cover my face with that one. Let's go on. Mag nie voorsien word van meer as een energiebronnie, guys. No more than one energy supply, please. Dat sien jy, you can't put 2 batteries on it. No. Ja? Hakkies draad. Hy. Die gaping tussen die 2 elektrische heininge moet verskillende energiebronne hê en het moet minstens 2 meter wees. Wat? Nee. There must be a 2 meter gap between 2 different electric fences. Op baie wildsplaas het ons 'n heining, 'n stukkie pad en 'n heining. That must be 2 meters and they must have their own supply of energy. Yeah, but they're not combined to one line.
So,
that's fine.
So that means you
have 4 generators. As hierdie opening gesluit moet word, moet dit gedoen word deur middel van 'n nie elektriese geleidingsmateriaal. So if we must close this opening, let's say it has to be a gate. It must not be a conductive gate. It must be made out of wood. Hy mag weer eens, Roelof lag te veel. Hy mag nie 'n geleier wees nie, so Roelof. Daai ou uister zet ek wat jy op die plaas sê. Al die ding uit. Doringdraad of lemmetjiesdraad mag nie geelektrifiseer word. CJ, do not electrify barbed wire. It is illegal.
Sir,
in the southern tip of Africa.
Dan kijk. Maar so kan jy bouw op fence, dan jy bouw the barbed fence behind it, or like, there, like in front, so.
Mm-mm. Must be far away.
Double fence, sir.
Alright, let's go on. Alright, dele van die elektriese heining wat langs openbare pad of snelweg geïnstalleer is, moet geïdentifiseer word deur waarskuwing teken stewig teen die heiningpale te monteer. So guys, if you have a part of your electric fence that's next to a highway or a busy road, it must have safety warning signs. We can't expect Oom Piet not to go lay against the wire if he doesn't know. He must know, because if he gets shocked and he gets hurt, you must pay. As hy man in het raak, en daar was die baarkie sê.
Hy vind sy vir Oompie. Is pa my Oompie?
Nee, Oompie is pa my nou uit. Die energiewerker. Ja, maar die energiewekker, of my werker, die energiewekker. Sy aarddelekordes moet die grond tot 'n diepte van 1 meter binnen dring. So our earthing spike. Almost. Our earthing pipe must be down at least for 1 meter. That copper pin must go down for 1 meter. Verbindingsgeleiers wat van binnengeboue bedryf word, moet effektief geïsoleer word van die geaarde strukturele dele van die gebou. So just make sure that all of your conduct is inside a building. Must be put so that it's earthed. So if somebody does touch it, they don't shock.
Earth, wind, fire.
Only the avatar can master. Let's go on. Sorg moet gedra word om skade aan die verbindingsleiers met te vermy as gevolg van gevolge van dierehoeve en trekkerwiele wat die grond sink. So we just make sure that if these animals or tractors driving over this electrical line, it must be deep enough so they don't damage it. You can't have your 10,000 cattle running over that line and then when cattle number 9,999 goes over, it shocks. And when the tractor goes over and then Pete follows the tractor, you shock Pete. You can't do that.
Call me Pete.
Okay, I'll use another name, Brandon, next time.
No, I feel like Pete is seeing you.
No. Hier is ook Klaas, los op Piet uit. As die elektrische heining sy koppelingsgeleiers na by die oorhoofse kragling installeer word, moet die verhoogte wees soos volg. So guys, when we have a line under a Eskom line, it must be set at the following heights and the following volts. Daar kom JP is in die fight. So the reason for this is if there should be a bugger up and the line should fall on your electrical line, it's going to overcharge your electric line. So you have to protect your fence by making it this height and this volt. So if there is a line that falls on it, the voltage will kick off of the earthing cable. So hy trip die krag, want hy weet hy kan net soveel 1000 volts vat. Dan trip hy. As jy nie daai aardkabel het nie, en die Eskom lijn wat levendig is val op jou kraaglijn, dan braai jy kudu, sonder dat jy kudu braai. Jy braai kudu en poacher, alles gelijk. Alles.
So maar is.
Mense, onthou, jy moet ook jou kraag afskakel, please switch off the electricity when fixing. Skakel jou kraag af tydens instandhouding, Roelof. Yes. Hierso, waar elektrische heining bedoel is vir afskrikmiddels vir voëls op geboue, mag geen elektrische heiningdraad verbind word aan 'n aardpenning. So guys, where we have a building electric fence, just basically to keep the birds away, we can't connect it to an earthing cable. It's gonna kill the bird. Ons kan nie dat doen nie. Yeah. Waar elektrische diereheining openbare pad kruis, moet 'n nie elektrifiseerde hek by 'n punt van die heining geïnstalleer word. So if there is a path where a public road crosses through your farm and you have an electric fence, we must have a gate at that point that is not electrified.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Ek sien, al is het Afrikaners, all of the South African people going now. So I'm just going to go through that gate. For our American friends, we have to keep it open for safety reasons. Unless they take the gate now. Ek swer die mense sit oor sy, dink hulle vir hulle self, what is happening here?
So, dink ek was, you paranoid man, you know, do this. You
know. All of these people here are right wing. Let's go on. Beskryf 'n manier om die aardingsdoeltreffendheid van die elektriese heining op 'n swak grondtoestande opgerig te verbeter. Goed vinnig haar opmaak vir die Engels. Ways of increasing the earthing efficiency of an electric fence. Increase the number of earth spikes. Run an earth return wire in parallel to the fence line and connecting the earth spikes in regular intervals. The main purpose of the conductor wire in electric fence is to carry the electric fence charge through the length of the fence. One type of wire that is not allowed to be electrified is barbed wire or razor wire. Double. Gaan nou breek wat. Die hoofdoel van die geleidingsdraad in elektriese heining is vervoer van elektriese spanning oor die hele lengte van die heining een soort omheiningsdraad wat nie geëlektrifiseer mag word nie, doringdraad of lemmetjiesdraad. Right. Ons gaan vinnig 'n breekie vat.